The promoter functions kind of like a Pol2 promoter, being upstream of the transcript. However, it is on a different element. The upstream region of the element is the 3' UTR of the other element. Interestingly, this extended element marked here is in green is structurally and functionally equivalent to an LTR and not to a line anymore. If you look at it closely at the extended element, the upstream sequences are identical to the downstream sequences, and this extended element actually looks like an LTR. This would raise a lot of new questions. So maybe head A should rather be regarded as an intermediate between LTR and non-LTR. Despite all the different mechanisms explained here, there are actually similarities for elongation by telomerase and by transposable elements. For both, RNA is template for reverse transcriptation. For both, the 3' end and the chromosome terminus serves as a primer. For both, a protein with template RNA associates with the terminus. The differences are that telomerase polymerizes the same short sequence complementary to its internal RNA template, while reverse transcriptase of a transposon adds a very long sequence beginning at the 3' end of the template RNA. Coming back to the first question we were asking ourselves, are all transposable elements selfish? Transposable elements are usually regarded as being selfish and as being parasitic. But now we have seen, taking the example of telomeres of Drosophila, that the transposons het A and TART are the first transposable elements discovered to be assigned an essential cellular function. They have maintenance function at the termini of chromosomes in Drosophila and thereby counterbalance terminal loss. They jump to the end of chromosomes and expose themselves to this terminal loss, just to shield the rest of the chromosome. They sacrifice themselves because they themselves have no advantage, they are being broken down.
In this way, these elements, being transposons, are not selfish DNA at all, but rather altruistic DNA. This lets us believe that there are more undiscovered transposons serving a function. Het A and TART are beneficial for Drosophila because they sacrifice themselves to protect the chromosomes. Indirectly, they may benefit from this because if the host benefits, the transposable elements will eventually be passed on to the next generation more often. In this case, the transposable elements and the host benefit from each other. This means Het A and TART are neither selfish nor altruistic.
After hearing all this, it seems like we learned a lot of new facts today. But as always, this brings with it a lot of new open questions that leave room for speculations and further studies. What was first, telomerase or retrotransposons encoding reverse transcriptase? What was first, Het A or TART, and how are they different if they serve the same function? Has Het A arisen from telomerase and is actually not a transposon? What is it that leads Het A and TART only to chromosomal ends? We haven't mentioned this, but why does TART have an endonuclease domain if it transposes only to chromosomal ends and does need to cut DNA? TART produces a lot of antisense RNA. Why is that? What is supplying the RT for heat het A transposition? It does not encode it itself. Is it using the RT of TARRT? Are new telomeric additions derived from other telomeric copies of the elements, or from internal master genes? It is clear to us now that Het A and TARRT have a role in chromosome structure of Drosophila. This suggests that maybe there are other transposable elements that serve specific functions, maybe even in other organisms.